The beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Genesis 6, and the sons of God lusted after women. Wala na nang explain ko. Ti paano na yan? Di na nagkuha sang binhi nga ti ano na man? Ano na, how does it work? The Bible does not explain. But some people want to understand. So this is how they came about in explaining it. These demons or these spirit beings are able to switch between male and female. They are able to collect the sperm of whoever they violate, either in a heterosexual or homosexual manner. That is why in Sodom and Gomorrah, the wickedness of Sodom and Gomorrah was so great, which I believe had an angelic, fallen angel influence in that city. But that's another story. And they collect the sperm, and when they have affair with women, then that is what they use, the sperm of whoever their victim is, but they have already impacted that sperm with their own spirit so that the sperm already carries the whatever it is that they have. This is how they explain it, because I really tried to understand, because I said, how can it work? And you will find so many explanations there, I will not waste my time on that anymore. So, most human sightings of ghosts actually involve these embodied spirits. They are not yet the fallen angels that we are talking about. Fallen angels are an entirely different class of spirit beings. Ining nakita din yung mga white lady, permila na na-accident, hindi siya na ng lugar. They are disembodied spirits. They are looking for bodies to possess. They are also called familiar spirits in the book of Deuteronomy because they imitate people who are dead. They pretend to be like your tatay, your nanay, your whatever, just to keep you talking to them, and without you knowing it, you are already committing an abomination, because speaking with the dead is an abomination to the Lord in the book of Deuteronomy. Mediums and spiritists who facilitate speaking with the dead are killed in the Old Testament because it is an abomination to the Lord. So we are actually dealing with these embodied spirits. Okay. Talking with familiar spirits, demons, is abomination to the Lord. That is very severely prohibited in Leviticus chapter 19 and Deuteronomy chapter 18. Remember, in Luke chapter 16, there is no crossing of the divide between the eternal states and earth. So, hindi ka magsiling, si ano to, si amo ni, si amo na. Ari kagali, ari. No, wherever they land, that is where they land. The Christian has angelic protection. Because before I get deeper into this, some of you may begin to develop some unpleasant feelings. So I intercept this with a promise of the word of the Lord. At least two. Receive this in your spirit. Hebrews 1:14 and Psalm 91:10. Angels are sent to minister to you. And they are not alone sent to you. Always in the plural. Whenever a child of God is mentioned in the Bible, nga ginaservisan sang angel, that's never only one. It's always ministering spirits or angels. Psalm 91:10, no evil will befall you, nor will any plague come near your tent, for he will give his angels charge concerning you to guard you in all your ways. So this is how it might look like in the realm of the spirit, something like that. So Enoch intercedes for these fallen angels, but the Lord decides, no, this is, according to Enoch, this is what it is said, go say to the watchers of heaven, because they are called watchers, the fallen angels who had sex with these women, who have sent thee to intercede for them, you should intercede for men and not men for you, wherefore ye have left high, holy, and eternal heaven and lain with women and defied yourselves, so there is no salvation for them, saith the Lord. And from this interaction came the Nephilim. Now, there is a schedule for this disembodied spirit. May tiuna sila nga punpuno na sila kag husgaran. In fact, they are afraid that it will come prematurely. When the demons in Gadara or the legions in Matthew 8:29 were confronted by Jesus, ang ila question, have you come here to torture us before the appointed time? Torture us. There is only one place of torture for them. That is the lake of fire. Wala pang ila schedule to be thrown to the lake of fire. If you will read this passage, they even ask if they could please stay in the area because precisely they are called familiar spirits. They already know the neighborhood. They already know all the addicts, all the honky-tonks, all the blah, 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 all the illegal activities. They feel good already about that place. So maski baboy na lang ilang katuan, nag-aayo sila, pwede lang nga hindi kami diri pagpahalinon. This line of the Lord Jesus Christ is a favorite tool of mine when I was still very active in spiritual warfare deliverance ministry, because kung tig-aulogin ang demonyo nga hindi maglakat, hindi magwa, gambal ko, kung hindi pagid kada magwa, I will ask the Lord to bring you to hell before your time. Because amo gina ang ilang kulbaan, no? So, recap. Demons are disembodied spirits. They are spirits of the product of the union of the fallen angels of Genesis 6 with women of those days. They produce Nephilims and giants. They became disembodied or lost their human body habitations during the flood and when David killed the Anakites. They are still on earth. They are looking for bodies to possess. They are properly called demons or familiar spirits. And the Lord warns, before the second coming of Jesus Christ, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the days of the coming of the Son of Man. They are expected to increase their activity in these last days. So, now, what is the difference between demons and fallen angels? Number one, demons are spirits who lost their bodies and are looking for bodies to possess. Fallen angels have their own celestial bodies. They do not necessarily need a human body to possess. That's one very important distinction. That's why when you deal with a fallen angel, not a demon, and you say, come out in Jesus' name, the fallen angel might scratch his head. How can I come out when I'm already out? But that kind of a command works only with demons. Demons need human bodies to express themselves. Fallen angels have no such needs. One indicator of difference between demons and fallen angel is what Jesus said in Matthew 12:43. When the unclean spirit comes out of the man, he walks through arid places. He just walks. He cannot afford Cebu Pacific or Philippine Airlines. He does not fly because he is not a spirit being, fallen angel that flies. He just walks. Okay? So that is what is. Now, you will ask, why go into all this distinction? Why? It is important to know the distinction. I will discuss this in greater detail in lesson 4, but tonight I just need to say one thing. You do not fight with fallen angels in the way that you fight demons. We are given authority to rebuke demons and to command them to go out in Jesus' name. But you don't go to Mount Canlaon and address the territorial spirit and rebuke him in the same way that you would rebuke a demon inside a human body. In the first place, I want you to read the book of Jude tonight when you go home. Even Archangel Michael was very respectful to Satan. And Jude said in the book of Jude that some people have no respect for spirit beings. They slander celestial bodies, which the Bible prohibits because they are higher in authority over us And the only correct way to rebuke them is to invoke a higher authority and not at your own level. We will discuss that in greater detail in lesson 4. Kay kun hangkatun mo tapungulay ang fallen angels, I will not mention names, but I want you, as I talk now, I will not mention names, but I want you to remember, very recently, brethren in the Lord who went around rebuking spirits, I will ask you, what happened to them? What happened to their health? What happened to their sanity? What happened to their thinking? What happened to their physical bodies? What happened to them? I will not elaborate further, because you don't fight fallen angels in the same way that you fight demons. A second important difference is, remember, demons originated from sexual sin, the illicit sex between angels and humans. Therefore, there is one characteristic of demons. Demons are sex hungry. They gravitate towards sex. Illicit sex opens up us up to demons. Look at the demonized man of Gerasene, Mark chapter 5, verse 15. He was naked. Demons love to display nudity, nudity. They are going back to their historic entry into the world, which is sexual affair with the daughters of men. They want that repeated all over. That's why demonized persons, before you know it, when the demonization gets deeper, they begin to disrobe themselves. I want you to recall all the Kaluluoy people that you see here in Bacolod who just walk down the road. Because they just go from dangerously clothed to no more clothes. That is a work of demon. Demons want people to think dirty sex. Sex is good. The Lord created sex to be good between husband and wife in the context of marriage. When the demons left this man, he clothed himself because he was now in his proper mind. Why was Mary Magdala? Actually the Bible does not directly say so, but it's just a conclusion made by some students of the Bible. Why did she have 7 demons? Sex. So sexual perversion opens the door to extreme demonization. That is why sexual sin is a specially identified sin in 1 Corinthians 6. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ himself? Verse 15, shall I then take the members of Christ and unite them with a prostitute? Never. Do you not know that he who unites himself with a prostitute is one with her in body? For it is said that two shall become in one flesh. But he who unites himself with the Lord is one with him in spirit. Flee from sexual immorality. Now, listen to this. Look at this. All other sins a man commits are outside his body, but he who sins sexually sins against his own body. Why? Why is this kind of sin specially mentioned as a unique sin? All other sins are lumped up into one category. They are committed outside the body. But this one sin is committed against your own body. Why? Because it brings in a spirit into your own body. All the other sins that you commit may not necessarily, as yet, immediately bring in a spirit into your body. But remembering Genesis 6, the sexual encounter between the sons of God, the angelic beings, and the daughters of men, then you have an understanding why this is a specially mentioned sin. Towards the end of this, we will talk about deliverance on this subject matter. So, demons are earthbound, disembodied spirits. They are the foot soldiers of Satan, his ground troops, and they are the ground implementers of Satan's agenda against us. But Christ already broke Satan's head at the cross. Okay. Now, what can Satan do in general? Things he tells his demons to do. This is a laundry list from the Bible. Number one, they can inflict diseases or inabilities. Some diseases are spirit inflicted. In this particular case, Matthew chapter 9, verse 33, maisa di ka tao, hindi ka hambal, kag bulag, kag mute. And when the demon was driven out, the man who had been mute spoke. Abi lang nila, apa, pero sang na-rebuke ang demonyo, nakahambal. So, demons can inflict diseases or disabilities. Mental disorder can also be caused by demons. Why? Mark chapter 5 verses 4 to 5. There was a man who is identified to have been possessed by an unclean spirit. He lived among the tombs and no one could bind him anymore, not even with a chain. So, nagbuang siya, violent siya, hindi siya ma-contain. And when Jesus confronted him, "Come out of the man, you unclean spirit." And the Lord asked him, "What is your name?" He replied, "My name is Legion, for we are many." And he begged him earnestly not to send them out of the country. And the Lord gave them permission. Kaya nangayo sila sa mga pigs na lang. Amunin nga si Brother Butch, hindi ginagid magtandog sang pigs. Kay amunin ang ginaamag sang mga ano. So they went to the pigs. Okay? So, impurity also, impure spirit. There was a man possessed by an impure spirit. I want you to notice where this man was. He was where? Now, there is a common belief that demons cannot share a place with the Holy Spirit. You can actually bring a demon with you to church. Even Satan has no problem coming to the presence of God in heaven to ask permission to torment Job. So please do not kid ourselves that, "Oh, I always go to church," so the demon may not be able to stand. Oh, he might even like it more. Okay, so but he was in the synagogue and he was possessed by an impure spirit. So what do you want with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know you, the Holy One of God. "Be quiet," said Jesus sternly. "Come out of him." The impure spirit shook the man violently and came out of him with a shriek. Okay, we will discuss this towards the end. Manifestations, when demons are present and they are confronted, they usually manifest. Ginabalan siya ni Jesus, "Hibos, come out." Tuntogid nga demonyo, nagwa siya. Pero nagbilin pa siya rawit nga singgit. No? Okay. When a person prays over us to release us from demonization, many times there are physically felt manifestations nga matakos git. Do you know that demons can also be by false doctrine? Some people do not know that they have been demonized by deceiving spirits. They are socially well-dressed. They are very good-looking people. There's nothing wrong with them, but they follow deceiving spirits and things, doctrines taught by demons. 1 Timothy chapter 4. You read 1 Timothy chapter 4 in your own time, because if I touch this topic, I will digress and it will eat up 30 minutes of my time, which I do not have. But deceiving spirits and things taught by demons is another form of demonization. So, posibleng gidyaya nga ka-professional sa imo, ka-nami sa imo, nakapabelo ka, dason ka-kind gid sa imo, pero why ka-kabalo, demonized ka? May something sa kabuhi mo nga naisahan ka, naintuan ka. Demons also possess. They can enter bodies and possess, just like this Mark chapter 9 story. So, when the possession came, this person was robbed of his speech. And when it seizes him, it throws him to the ground. He foams at the mouth, gnashes his teeth, and becomes rigid, which to me is a description of epileptic seizure. Daw kun inyo, tanaw mo daw kuyap. Among the most severe forms of manifestation when a demon is rebuked and commanded to come out is amuni. Nagawaras, nagapirek, nagalibot ang mata, nagabura, gangurob, kag nagatiskog. Okay. Even Jesus experienced that in his deliverance ministry. Okay. Another case of possession, the deaf and the mute spirit. Okay. And then, here, another surefire form of demonization. Engagement in occultism and astrology. Ang occultism, sigurado gid niya nga avenue for demonization. And this is condemned in Isaiah chapter 47, verse 12. Keep on then with your magic spell, with your many sorceries, which you have labored at since childhood. Perhaps you will succeed, perhaps you will conquer. All the counsel you have received has only worn you out. Let your astrologers come forward. That's why, hindi na inosinti, kag hindi na cute when you ask one another, ano ka ng imong zodiac sign? Ay, ano kagali? Wow! Diba, si compatible kita. Wow, terrible. So, ang basis mo for decisions, ang compatibility is the zodiac sign. Ay, hindi ka maglakat subong kay ang bulan mo, hindi ni mayogid. No? Na, muna. Sinina, hindi ka kung magwa si mo balay kay siling sang zodiac sign, may delikado ka sa kalayo kag bato. Di pagtabok yagid na ipit siya sang truck ang ngalan sang guma Firestone. Te, patay. Using demons tempts us, robs us, oppresses us, can even kill us physically if we are not careful. And he carries out his territorial spirits to carry out his worldwide plan. He uses demons to carry out his territorial plans. Now, mahambal ka mo, ti Christian naman, Kuya Brother Lindon, hindi na kuya ma-demonize kay Christian. I have the Holy Spirit inside me. Okay. Damo-damo, balansang pwede mahimo ang demonyo sa aton. Okay. Number one, he opposes the movement of the gospel. He prevents understanding, he blinds minds, and he hinders the progress of preachers. Basahan nyo na lang Luke 8:12, 2 Corinthians 4:3-4, 1 Thessalonians 2:18. So, when you go to a Bible study and you do not pray, when you go on sharing the gospel, you do not pray, nauna na to ang kontra sa imo, kay ginbutangan niya na sang kulap, ang huna-huna sang ginaplanuhan mo nga i-witnessan. That is what demons do against Christians. In the spiritual realm, there may be occasions when you will feel that you were engaged in hand-to-hand combat with the spirit of a demon, because Ephesians 6:10 says, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities." In my own personal experience, wrestling with the spirit being, at least in my own observation, comes in especially involving the spirit of depression. Remember, wrestling is a contact sport. Why do I say nga depression together with panic attack and with fear? Why? Because mabatsyagan mong physical effect. Daw hindi ka kaginawa. Daw hindi ka kagiho. Daw hindi ka ka-rebuke in Yeshua's name. Daw ka-real gid sang dumog. Sometimes it is in a dream. When you are under attack, remember, recall all your experiences. When you have all those sensations that you are wrestling with a demon spirit, your spirit is wrestling against this spirit, because the word of the Lord says, we wrestle not against flesh and blood. So, it is a hand-to-hand combat experience. Ang nakita ko gid, depression, discouragement, beginning this depression and discouragement. Mahulog ka di sa depression and discouragement, it can lead to death. People can get to being suicidal when they are driven to depression and discouragement, when you lose your zeal for life, when you lose your joy. Another thing that demons do with the mind is accuse us day and night. Revelation 12:10. He is called the accuser of the brethren. Hindi siya accuser of the world. Accuser of the brethren. That's why sometimes, even myself, I would sometimes have thoughts crossing my mind. Why gid ko? Hipokritiko ka? Why ka gid? May ka lang pambalun? Kisa ka libong, hindi na naghahalin ng mga kaisipan ni man. Where do these thoughts come from? In Acts chapter 5, verses 1 to 5, in the confrontation between Peter and Ananias and Sapphira, take note of the counter of Peter against Ananias and Sapphira, who pretended that they were giving the whole purchase price of the thing that they sold. Ano siling ni Peter? Why has Satan so filled your heart that you should lie to the Holy Spirit? So, Satan can fill your heart, your thoughts, your mind. I will show that in greater detail karon. Extramarital sex, 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 5. I will point that out. There is a specific slide for that karon. Occupation with worldly pursuits, 1 John chapter 2, verses 15 to 16. When you, as a Christian, are not thinking of your role in the kingdom, but thinking of the world, worldly pursuits, material things, that is a form of demonization that is not very apparent, but you are demonized. When you depend on human strength to do things, when there is spiritual pride and arrogance, division of the church, causing churches to quarrel, is one of the devil's schemes. But I want to point out tonight a special case. When you are overly worried, when you are a warrior, over-concerned, I want to inform you by the authority of God's word that the devil is nearer to you than anybody else. 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 6 to 10. Look at the words of the Bible. Humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that He may exalt you in due time. Cast all your worries or cares upon Him, because He cares for you. Be sober and vigilant. Your opponent, the devil, is prowling around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. When Peter said this under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, the context of the warning is with people who are prone to cares and fears and anxieties. He was not talking about general sins. He was talking about the particular problem of lack of faith. Inablang, hindi kagid kasalig nga himunan ka ni Lord. Hindi kagid kasalig nga masolve ang problem mo. Do hindi kagid believe nga maumpawani. So palibog. Dasun pagtanaw mo sang imo nga papilis daw wala naman palibog. Naglibog ang ulo mo nga wala kay na ginapalibugan. So nagworry ka nga hindi na ni normal. Dapat ya may ginapalibugan gid ko. Wow. So tukbon kagid sang demonyo. Ano ang koneksyon sini sa sina? Kung hindi ni pwede mahimo sa Christian, kay Christian naman ko, what is this warning doing here when a Christian cannot be demonized? Ginsulat ni sa Christians. Be careful with anxiety. Palibog. You are a candidate for demonic attack. Number two, be careful with unforgiveness. Resentment, special case. Matthew 18. This is the parable of the unforgiving servant. May servant, ginpatawad, happy gid siya. Pagkat guaya sa balay sang master, may namit siyang servant, may utang man siya. Hindi niya pagpatawaron. Ano ang ginimo niya? Gin papriso yagid. pagkabati sang mga neighbors, gin-report sa master. This is what the master did. Verse 32. Then his lord, after that he had called him, said unto him, O thou wicked servant, I forgave thee all that debt because thou desirest me. Shouldn't you also have had compassion on your fellow servant, even as I had pity on thee? And his lord was wroth or angry, and delivered him to the tormentors, King James Version, till he should pay all that was unto him, due unto him. So likewise shall my heavenly Father do also unto you, if from your hearts you forgive not everyone his brother their trespasses. Kung hindi ka mapinatawaron, nag-warning si Jesus, likewise, I will deliver you to the tormentors. Tormentors are demons. I will show you scriptures that show that God delivers people who are very hard-headed to being handled by demons, if only to teach them a lesson, because they don't want it the gentle way, they want it the torture way. Okay, I'll teach you in the school of torture, because you cannot forgive. I will make you feel what it feels like, what you're doing to other people. I will send you to that tormentors. What Satan does to Christians? Satan sidetracks us from undivided attention and devotion to God. This is one of his most subtle attacks. Tanawan niyo bala ang plaster sa 2 Corinthians chapter 11. And I am afraid that a large majority of Christians are under this category. Look at this. I hope you will put up with a little of my foolishness, but you're already doing that. I am jealous for you with a godly jealousy. I promise you to one husband to Christ, so that I might present you as a pure virgin to him. But I am afraid that just as Eve was deceived by the serpent's cunning, your minds may somehow be led astray from your sincere and pure devotion to Christ. Si Eve na intuan, kita nga gapa Christian, nga hindi conscious ang aton bridal commitment to Jesus Christ, because bride na di ang context, I promise you to one husband, but we do not behave like the bride of Christ. We are candidates for demonization, just as Eve was deceived by the serpent. So, Satan and his demons also incite persecution. Klaro gini, especially in the last days. Pwede siya maglabugay sa mga persecutors. The devil will put some of you in prison and you will suffer persecution. Hindi na iya sa mga politiko, hindi na iya sa gobyerno, iya na sa yawa plano. The devil desires to gain a foothold. Amo na in-explain ta last time, Ephesians 4:26-27. May area of control siya sa aton nga kabuhi, whether it is temper, pornography, addiction, anything. Basta may foothold lang siya, any way by which he can control us. Heretical doctrine, ignorance and doctrinal immaturity to bring believers in actual demonic fellowship. In 1 Corinthians chapter 10, wala siya kabalo, nag-intra-intra siya sa food offered to idols. Let's be careful with the food that we are buying if they have been prayed over, like if they bear the stamp of halal. They have been prayed over with Muslim prayers. Let's just be careful. Daw nagakitid ang ato ni nga mga choices, kaya daw tanan na lang may stamp. And